The Lord. What a mighty God we serve.
Crown, crown, oh, crown, crown, oh, crown, crown, oh, crown, crown.
It's always a blessing to come your way. That is Uncle Two on the background. Wherever that you are, how are you doing? God bless you for tuning in tonight. You can get us live on Facebook. You can get us live on Magic Touchh Radio. Live. You can download the app. And at the same time, you can get us on TuneIn Radio. You can search Magic Touchh and you can get us there. I'll humbly ask that wherever that you are listening to us, you just get in touch with a friend. Share our videos. Get someone to be connected, because tonight I believe God for his word. The number 8 is a number of new beginnings. And I know God will do something new in your life. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, you are in my rich and woe. Yes, you are in my rich and woe. 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 You are in my rich and woe.
Thank you, Jesus. Tonight, if you are here with me, let's turn our Bibles to the book of Psalm, chapter number 27. Psalm, chapter number 27. Somebody praise the Lord right now. It is so amazing that we are in the month of August. Maybe you were caught up in fear that you did not even believe and know, or you were not rest assured that you will be able to see the month of August. But here we are. All glory belongs to Jesus. All the praise belongs to God. Kindly share the videos, connect a brother, a friend to listening to us on TuneIn, Magic Touch app on your phones, and your life will never be the same tonight.
Yeah.
chapter number 27. Psalm chapter number 27. Wow, that was Abba Seal.
Erazi. I wonder about certain years, I see.
I'm so much confident for the fact that this month God will do something new in your life. How are you doing? Praise God. Let us begin to praise God. Father, we thank you tonight. We bless your name. Moro sa talaba simbre ando lalabo sabari kirabado saba. Lebro zibri alaba sa taraba lo sebre kelabra sondo lobro sande lebre karaba zondo robo saba. Lebre sabrando robo sabaraba. Somebody lift up your voice. Begin to praise God. Begin to praise God. Begin to praise God. Somebody lift up your voice. Begin to praise God. Lift up your heart in a time of praise. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Let us go before God with thanksgiving. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rabba zobre kata ya rabba zabalaba. Rema zondolo bro zibri alabra zibri alabaraba skimri alaba kalaba zondelebre kalabra zundalaba. Rema zondelebre karaba zabalabro zabranda rabba zabra lebre zabra labra zabra labra. Lebro zabaraba reba zabaraba teraba zolebre karaba zabaraba. We thank you, Lord, tonight. Rabba Zolebre caraba, zabra labra, zabra labra caraba, lebra, zabra caraba, zabra labra, cashabra laba, rabba, sacaraba, lebra, sabra caraba, zaba, rabba, cataraba, zabalaba, calabra, saba, lebro, sabaraba, kilabro, sabaraba, zebre, araba, zabaraba. We give you all the praise, O God. We give you all the praise. Hallelujah. Hello, Him. We love you, Lord. Rabba, zebre, cadabra. Let's hear the word of God. Babe, let's hear the word of God.
Psalm chapter 27, verses 1, I read, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?"
Hold on there. The Lord is my light and salvation. There are two key words there. Light and salvation. Remember that wherever that there is light, darkness cannot comprehend. It means that when light appears, darkness disappears. The Lord is my light. So John said that I came to bear witness to that light. John chapter number 1. It means that when God becomes our light, our way is always clear. And he proceeded to say that the Lord is my salvation. You and I, we have been saved by grace. It means that the grace of God have been able to keep us alive up to this time. So if God has been your life right from the beginning of the year, January up to this time, and the Lord has been your salvation, he says that whom shall I fear? The key word there is him. It represents a human entity. When you are caught up with fear, what do? When you are caught up with the things that overwhelms your mind and your heart, what do? But David said that the Lord is my light and salvation. Tonight, the Lord has been your light and your salvation. That is the reason why you are not scared about what life will throw against you. That is the reason why you are not scared about the circumstances that are prevailing in the present day. That is the reason why, though you may be down, but you see yourself coming out. He said that the Lord is my light and salvation.
Amen.
Whom shall I fear? If there is somebody at that workplace that is sitting on your happiness, traumatizing you, tonight you just want to declare and say, Lord, you have been my light and salvation. The fact that you are here does not guarantee what tomorrow holds. But the fact that you are with God guarantees that tomorrow you will take that which is yours. So he continued to say that the Lord is my light and my salvation. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He said that let there be light, and there was light. There is something unique about the light that is being thrown our way by the power and the presence and the supremacy of God. Why do I say this? Because the devil is scared of the light that you carry. Because the light becomes your anchor. Because the light becomes that which overshadows you. When someone is coming with the full force of God light, you can never be located to be destroyed. So he said that whom shall I fear? David was praising God for all that he has done for him. Tonight it is not David, but it is you. So you just want to say that, Father, I thank you because you have been my light and you have been my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall you fear? Tonight, in the name of Jesus, anything that has become a fear and it is tormenting your life, I speak in the name of Jesus, the the Son of the Living God, that you are coming out of your fears.
Amen.
Is it the fears of marriage? Is it the fears of losing your job? Is it the fear of losing your life? Is it the issues of life that you are battling with? But Bible said that the Lord is our light and our salvation. When God becomes your salvation, it means that he pulls you out of the place that you have been helpless into a place that you can get abundance of help.
Amen.
Somebody didn't get it. God puts you at a place that you will get help.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go ahead.
The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? 2.
Good evening, Mount Zion.
When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh.
Hold on there. He says that the Lord is my stronghold. The stronghold of my life.
Last 3 years, I had a chance to meet.
Of whom shall I be afraid?
On a job 3 years ago, we were.
When the wicked advanced against me.
Fell in love with her spirit.
Child of God, we live in a time and day.
Means God.
That the devices of the enemy has already been thrown ahead of us.
What you gonna do?
You need advanced knowledge to discern.
I said, well, what you
and be able to stand against the devices of the enemy.
Baby, it means that.
The devil has no power. But we have to be able to deal with its devices. So David said that the Lord is the stronghold of my life. When God becomes your stronghold, it means that you become so solid and so strong. It means that you are leaning on a dependable God. It means that nothing can move you, nothing can stop you, nothing can stand your way, because the Lord is your stronghold. Tonight the Lord shall be your stronghold.
Amen.
And there is nothing in life that you'll be afraid of.
Amen.
Say that the Lord is my stronghold. The Lord is my stronghold.
Amen.
Of whom shall I be afraid? The subject here is making reference to him. It's impersonating. It's referring to a man. David went through series of attacks.
And we're crying.
Went through series of all kinds of dehumanization. But thanks be to God. That he knew God, understood God, believed God, and God gave him victory over all the devices.
Amen.
The arrows, the powers of the devil that were being shot at him.
Amen.
Tonight you are alive. Tonight I am alive.
Yes,
it is not anything that we have done.
Lord.
It is not anything that we deserve.
Jesus.
It takes the grace and the mercy of God.
Oh,
it takes the power and the hand of God to sustain us up to this time. That is the reason why the Lord that we serve have become our light. He has become our salvation. He is the stronghold of our life. Somebody begin to declare, Father, I thank you for being my light. I thank you for being my salvation.
I thank you for being my stronghold.
I thank you for the month of August.
I give you all the praise
for all that you have done. Begin to praise God. Begin to praise God right now. Begin to praise God. Begin to praise God. Begin to praise God. In the name of Jesus, Father, we praise you. Father, we praise your name. We praise your name.
We give you all the praise. We give you all the praise, O God. God, for what you have done. All that you continue to do.
You have been our shield. You have been our stronghold. Tonight we give you praise, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We love you, Lord, for all that you have done. May your name be praised. May your name be lifted. May your name be praised. May your name be lifted. May your name be praised. May your name be lifted up. We thank you tonight, O God. We bless you tonight, O God.
Then
you said you have been my light. You have been my salvation. Tonight I thank you for my life. I thank you for my wife. I thank you for the giftings. I thank you for the blessings. I thank you for the protection. I thank you for your provisions. I thank you for the love. I thank you for the kindness, O God. I thank you for your goodness, O God. I thank you for all that you have done. I thank you for all that you are doing. May your name be praised, O God. 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 We love you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. We bless and praise your name. You are God and God alone. At the mention of your name, every knee bow. At the mention of your name, every tongue confess. We thank you tonight. We praise your name tonight. We lift up our voices. We lift up our hands. All that we are saying, Father, may your name be lifted, O God. May your name be praised, O God. May your name be lifted, O God. May your name be praised, O God. May your name be lifted, O God. May your name be praised, O God. We give you all the praise. We love you. We thank you. We worship you. We lift up our voices. We say, glory, glory be to your name. Glory, glory, glory be to your name. Glory, glory, glory be to your name. We give you all the worship tonight. We thank you because you have been our stronghold. You have been our stronghold. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus.
Power in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power.
Ecclesiastes chapter number 9, the verse 11.
Break it.
Ecclesiastes chapter number 9, the verse 11.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
There is something that happened, I think it happened on Tuesday.
Jesus.
In heaven.
There is a
that a whole garage came down.
Jesus.
And vehicles were being crashed and mashed. This is what I call divine escape. Because our wives, our children, they go to school, they park their cars under these garages. You don't look for trouble, but trouble is always looking for us. Cars were being submerged. Not a single soul became a victim of this incident. It could happen at any place, at any time. If it hadn't been the Lord who was on our side, where will you and I be? At times we drive anywhere, anyhow. But yesterday we get to our destination safe. Child of God, there is a hand that is always protecting us and holding us. I don't know about you, but as for me, God has been good to me. I don't know about you, but God has been so gracious unto me. I am who I am because of who God has made me to be. Give God praise tonight. The fact that we are in the month of August is a sign that God will take you to the end of the year. And you will not end there. God will cause you to see the years ahead. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Ecclesiastes chapter number 9, verse 11. Let's hear the word of God.
Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verses 11, I read. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong.
Hold on there. Bible said that I saw something else under the sun. That the race is not to the swift. When we're talking about someone who is swift, it means that that person is very sharp. That person is very smart. That person is very intelligent. I mean, such people, you don't struggle to teach them anything. They just get it at just a little command, and they get it and they are running with it. And he said that all the battle to the strong. We don't have anything. We don't fight with omniscience. The battle is not to the strong. It is not how well you have prepared for the battle. Go ahead.
No bread to the wise.
He said no food to what? To the wise. Go ahead.
Nor riches to men of understanding.
Wealth to those that are brilliant.
Nor favor to men of skill.
Nor favor to the men that are skilled, that are learned. Go ahead.
But time and chance happen to them all.
He said, but time and chances happens to them all. Life is a race. But don't compete with someone, compete with yourself. Life is a battle. Don't battle with anybody else and pretend to be somebody else. But find yourself in your own enterprise. Compete with yourself, battle with yourself to be the best person for tomorrow. Say the race is not to the swift, or the battle to the strong, nor does food come to the wise, or wealth to the brilliant, or favor to the learned. You could see that somebody is a learner, but the person is not doing well in life. You could see that somebody is brilliant, but nothing is coming out of his brilliance. You could see that somebody got wealth, but his wealth is not taking him or her to any place. Bible said that time and chances happens to them all. It means that it is God who calls. It is God who blesses. It is God who establishes. Therefore, tonight, anybody under the sound of my voice, you're not going to use your own strength to struggle.
Amen.
In life. That is not your portion.
Amen.
But I see the favor of God falling upon your life.
Yes, Lord.
I see God seeing you through this month of August. I see God manifesting himself with greater things in your life.
Yes, Lord.
I see God unfolding your miracle, your testimony, your breakthrough, and it is coming, and it is now.
In the name of Jesus.
Say that time and chances happens to them all. So if somebody is highly above and you are nowhere near that person, don't be jealous, because what God is about to do for you, is going to blow your mind.
Amen.
And I see men and women in this locality, in this metroplex, all over the place that are listening to me right now, that understand that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the stronger. If the battle was to the stronger, then Nebuchadnezzar could have won. Are you here with me? Then Goliath could have won. But victory belongs to Jesus. The victory is in the hands of God.
Yes, Lord.
And it pleases him to release it. Yeah. If it wasn't the hand of God that brought the people of Israel out of Egypt from the hands of Pharaoh, they could have been in bondage for years. But thanks be to God.
God
said that it is not about the one that is swift, but it is about whom God can do. It is not about the learned. It's not about the brilliant. It's not about the skillful. It is not about the intelligent. But it is about what I can do. And tonight I see God. Your effort cannot bring it. But God can bring it your way.
Lord.
You have tried it so many times. You have believed God for so many times. You have stood on your feet for so many times. And it is not yielding the results that you need. I came to proclaim a good news to you.
Amen.
That God is about turning the situation on your behalf. Bible said that time and chances happens to them all.
Amen.
Therefore, it is your season. It is your time. The book of Ecclesiastes talks about timings and seasons. Knowing the time in which you are to operate and to understand and discern what God can do.
Amen.
And tonight I came to pronounce over your life that the struggle is over.
Lord.
No more struggle in the name of Jesus. The battle is over.
The battle is
no
over.
More battles.
Amen.
The things that you have believed God
yes,
for
Lord.
This month of August, God is about to do something new.
Amen.
I see God beginning something
Amen.
New with you. I see God opening some doors.
Yes,
I see that marriage door open.
Yes,
I see that business door open.
Amen.
I see that contract open.
Amen.
I see God opening that scholarship for your son. I see God causing you to be accepted into that medical school.
Yes,
I see God doing something new.
Amen.
If you believe it, say, God, I believe this.
God, I believe this.
So Bible said, time and chances happens to them all. The fact that it is not yours today doesn't mean that God has forsaken you. The fact that you have not received that baby doesn't mean that you are going to be childless forever. God is working behind the scenes. And I see God unveiling and manifesting
Amen.
Himself so powerfully
Amen.
In your life. There's so many people that have received prophetic messages and it has come to pass. And I see so strongly, I sense it within my spirit tonight that somebody is listening to me right now. You are doing a job and your manager is on your neck. They are doing everything that they can to get you out of the place. But what God is saying to me tonight is that that person will go before you.
Amen.
I said that person will go before you.
Jesus.
I said that person will go before
Amen.
You. May God guarantee your work.
Amen. Amen.
May God guarantee it.
Amen.
I believe so. I tonight came with the anointing to release some encouragement into the soul that is downcast. Of favor to the learned or to the skillful. As for me, I have been to this school. I am credentialed. I am this. I am like that. I am that. You see, your miracle is tied to what God is doing. We have medical doctors that are broke. Are you here with me? We have lawyers that are broke. The positions that you can think of. People that were loaded and they have come back to square zero. You see, when God is blessing you, God does not consult any man.
Yes.
So that the race is not to the swift.
Not to be swift.
Tonight, tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not find yourself in any battle and lose. I see that victory is waiting for you. In the next 1 hour, in the next 24 hours, in the next days, in the following weeks ahead, in the months ahead, I see victory. Say, victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Let's turn our Bibles to the book of 1 Samuel chapter number 18. Samuel chapter number 18, the verse 11. First Samuel chapter number 18, the verse 11.
First Samuel chapter 18, verses 11. I read, and Saul cast the spear, for he said, I will pin David to the wall. But David escaped his presence twice.
Hold on there. He said that I will pin David to the wall. But David escaped it twice. He said that David eluded it twice. Any arrow, any javelin that have been thrown against you, I pray for divine escape for you.
Amen.
I said that I pray for divine escape for
in
you.
In the name of Jesus.
This was the time that Saul was pursuing David's life. But God gave David a divine escape.
Yes.
You are making a declaration tonight that any javelin that have been thrown against me from the wombs of hell, from the dark world, from the camp of my enemies, oh God, may I escape their devices.
Yes.
May my family
in the
escape
name
their
of
devices.
Jesus.
May my children escape their devices. Oh, yeah, lift up a prayer. Divine escape to Naraba Zibria Badia Talabian Dalaba. Yepadia Talabian delivery Cabrian delivery and delivery of Andu. Sabadia Talabian Talabian delivery Cabrian Dalaba Sabab. Yekabadia Talabalo Sabatayabian delivery of Yekabadia Talabalia Talabayaba. Yekabadia Talabalu. Let there be divine escape for us, O God. Let there be divine escape for our children. Let there be divine escape for our church members. Let there be divine escape for everybody listening to me tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, any satanic javelin that have been thrown up, that has been shot in the realms of the spirit, to bring anybody down tonight, let there be escape. Let there be Holy Ghost escape. Let there be a divine escape. For our children, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus, divine escape, let there be divine escape tonight. Let there be divine escape tonight. Let there be divine escape tonight. Let there be divine escape, O God. Any device that have been shot at against us in the realms of the spirit from the wombs of hell. Bible said, David escaped twice. Father, let there be a divine escape as we leave for work, wherever that we find ourselves in the satanic agendas.
May you preserve our lives in the name of Jesus. Father, preserve us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Our coming in, our going out, oh God, may you cause there to be a divine escape.
Somebody lift up your voice. Let there be divine escape in the month of August. In the month of August, Let there be a divine escape for somebody. Let there be a divine escape for somebody.
Father, may you arise, O God. Jehovah, may you arise, O God, and cause the enemies to be scattered in the name of Jesus. In the conniving, in the conducing, O God, in the plot, O God, in the snare of the fowler, my Lord, my God, they will never prevail in the name of Jesus.
Let there be a divine escape, O God. Anybody watching us tonight, anybody listening to us tonight, let there be a divine escape. Any arrow that has been shot up, any arrow that has been thrown up, any javelin that has been shut up to pin us down, to pin us against the wall, that we will not rise again, that we will be scattered, that we will be broken into pieces, that we will not survive. Father, we pray tonight, let us escape tonight. Let there be escape. Labro Sabata, Libro Zibrikata Yabadesa, Hey Padia Tayabaya, Ye Padia Tolebre Sabadia Tadaba, Ye Kabadu Sabata Yabandere Kabab, Libro Zibria Badia Tadaba, Ye Palus Nibria Bato Saba, Ye Padia Tadaba, Losibriaba, Ye Pa, Lepa Rosabadia Tadaba, Lekabro Sibria Bataya, Ye Kadabadia Tadabadia Tadaba, Sepadia Tadaba Ros Nibria Bata, Ye Kabrandere Sabadia Tadabaya, Ye Kabalu Sibria Badia Tadaba, Ye Kadabalo Sibria Badia Tadaba, Ye Kabro Sibria Badia Tadaba Losaba. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Bible said a wild sword threw the javelin to hit against David. Bible said that he eluded. There was an escape. Saul could not hit his target. May any arrow that has been shot in the realms of the spirit, may it never hit a target.
In the name of Jesus.
May it be rerouted.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. I said that may it be what? May it be diverted.
In the name of Jesus.
May it be diverted. Say every arrow.
Every arrow.
That has been shot.
That has been shot.
To pin me down.
To pin me down.
By prayer tonight.
By prayer tonight.
We take divine authority.
We take divine authority.
Let there be a divine escape.
Let there be a divine escape.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
For our children.
For our children.
They will not fall victims.
They will not fall victims.
Of their arrows.
Of their arrows.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Let there be a divine escape.
Let there be a divine
escape. Say divine escape.
Divine escape.
Say divine escape.
Divine escape.
Let there be a divine escape.
Let there be a divine escape.
For my life.
For my life.
In the name of
In
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I see God. Causing you to escape a serious demonic accident.
Yes.
Every accident is cancelled.
In the name of Jesus.
I said that every accident is cancelled.
In the name of Jesus.
Any accident that has been assigned to take off your life. By prayer tonight, let that accident be nullified. In the name of Jesus, let it be nullified.
Let it be nullified
with the blood of Jesus. Let there be escape. Let there be a divine escape for somebody right now. Let there be a divine escape in the name of Jesus. Tonight, oh Lord. According to your word, let evil slay the wicked and make those that hate me a desolate. Lord, may you hold us up as we go out so that our foot will not slip. This month of August, the Lord will hold you so that your foot will not slip. Your foot will never slip. I said that your foot will never slip. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Karabasuta yabasu karabata. Librosata yabari. Tonight, I am beginning a new series that I have titled, I Was Working and God Gave Me That Word. He said that the month of August, this is what I want you to release to my people. We always adhere to the voice of God. Paul said, I did not come to you by eloquency of speech, but I came under the demonstration of God's power and the Holy Spirit. We are here not because we want to be here. We are here because we have been sent by God. We have been anointed and imparted by God to release a word into your spirit so that with your faith and my faith, we will connect and we will be able to release prayer unto heavens. And heavens will respond to us. Because the Bible said that an effective prayer of the righteous in the book of James chapter number 5 availed much. It means that when we join our faith, one will pull 1,000 but two will pull 10,000, so that we can connect, we can join our faith and begin to release power, begin to release anointing, so that God will come through for you and me. So for the next few weeks that are ahead, we're going to deal with the act of patiently waiting.
Amen.
Somebody say the act of patiently waiting.
Act of patiently waiting.
The act of patiently waiting. Somebody turn his or her Bible to the book of Psalm chapter number 40. Waiting not in the essence of prayer and fasting, but waiting in the essence of believing God and trusting God. So patiently what? Waiting. The book of Psalm chapter number 40, the verse 1.
Psalms chapter 40 verses 1, I read. I waited patiently for the Lord.
Hold on there. David said that I waited patiently on what?
On the Lord.
Waited patiently on the Lord. Understand that waiting here is not in regards, or it is not related to prayer and fasting. It is in relation to when situations and timings and everything have caused you to be delayed in life. What do you do? The act of patiently waiting. David said in the book of Psalm chapter number 40 that I waited patiently on the Lord. Why did he state it patiently? It means that it will come into a time that we might feel that God is not doing anything. So it's either we go ahead of God or we begin to consult other gods.
Lift your worship.
So what does it mean to wait patiently on the Lord? In our 21st century, everything is on the fast pace. When you are going to the bank, we have something that we call drive-through. When you want to wash, we have the washer and the dryer. We have the microwave to heat our food. When you want to eat, you pass through the restaurant. You don't even get out of your car, and there is a drive-through. So we live in a time and day that if we are not careful, that if we are not very alert, we will rush into something and we will find ourselves doing something which has not been approved from God. So David said that I patiently waited on the Lord. What does it mean to patiently wait on the Lord? Waiting on God patiently is a position of hope and expectation. It is what? A position of hope and expectation. You hope for, but it is not now. You expect, but it is not now. Between the promise of God and the fulfillment of God's promise, there is a period of waiting. There is a period of waiting. And that is the time God uses to try us. That is the time God uses to test our faith. That is the time God uses to refine us. That is the time God uses to reshape our focus. That is the time God uses to redirect our ways. That is the time God uses to mold us. That is the time God uses to bring us to a place that we will understand that this one, it is not the doings of man, but it is the doings of the Lord. Can I hear amen?
Amen.
So waiting patiently on the Lord is a position, or you place yourself in a position that you hope on the Lord and you expect God to do something. May God grant you the grace. May God grant you the strength
yes,
to be able to wait on Him, to wait on him. Don't force yourself into any marriage because you are becoming old. Don't force yourself into any career because somebody is telling you to. Let the ways of God be perfected in your life.
Yes, Lord.
Patiently waiting on the Lord. David said that I waited patiently on the Lord. The second thing is that you are looking and believing God to do something.
Come on, say it again.
It means that you are not diverting to the left. You are not going to the right. You are not going ahead of God. You are not doing anything to disrupt what God is doing. But you have remained focused and attentive. It means that you have set your eyes, fixed your eyes on the Lord. The act of patiently waiting on the Lord. Child of God, you are listening to me right now. Maybe life have been disappointment after disappointment after disappointment. Life have been one story to the other. Life have been another song to the other. Life is beating you left, right, bottom, center. But I came to tell you that your waiting in the Lord will result something good. Your waiting in the Lord will result something better. Your waiting patiently in the Lord will result something that is magnificent. Bible said that in his time he makes all things beautiful. So God has said he will bless you. You have not seen the blessing, but you hope in waiting that it will manifest. That God is saying, I will get married. That gentleman has not proposed, but you hope and believe that that marriage will come on. You don't have that job, that dream job yet, but you have been promised that you're going to have this job, but you believe and hope and expect that God will do it. That is the time that you wait on God. That is the time that you build your inner endurance. That is the time that you build inner capacity. That is the time that God fills you with grace and strength. So that when the fulfillment of that promise come your way, you'll be able to hold on to it to eternity.
Amen.
Waiting patiently on God. The third thing is that what it means is that walking with God and holding on to your faith. Walking with God and holding on to your faith. Working with God and holding on to your faith. This is the time that you are not moved. This is the time that you are not shaking. This is the time that you are not being perplexed. This is the time that you become unstoppable. It's like you are not moved by what you see, what you hear. You are not moved by the things that others are saying, but you are moved by what God is doing.
Amen.
Come on.
Walking and holding on to your faith. Walking and holding on to your faith. In the period of waiting on God, there are so many questions that we ask ourselves. We ask the whys, we ask the hows, we ask the what, we ask the when, we ask God so many questions. But as you wait on God, as you patiently seek him, may you avoid asking God some questions.
Amen.
Because God can do what he can do. I mean, he's the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for him? There is nothing too hard. So you got to avoid asking God some questions, because the questions will move God. The questions will not change him, because what he has said he will do, that is what he will do. So we should avoid asking questions, the how, the when, the what, the why, and all that.
Fill me, God. Fill me, God.
In the book of chapter number 40, David expressed how he wanted God, he expected God relief for his life. The act of waiting patiently. Maybe you have been promised or you have been told about so many things, but as I speak to you now, none of them has been able to unfold or come to pass. That doesn't mean that you should throw in the towel, but it means that your hope, it means that your expectation, it means that you got to look up unto Him, the author and the finisher of our faith. Say, the author and the finisher of what? Our faith. You fix your eyes on the Lord and God alone. You set your eyes on God and God alone. Can I hear a big amen?
Amen.
Say, Lord, I will patiently wait on you. Because I know your timings are the best. I know that your timings are the best.
I know that your timings are the best.
The timings of God are the best.
Amen.
Somebody listening to me right now. God, the timings of God are what? The best. Let's read it. Psalm chapter number 40.
I waited patiently for the Lord, and He inclined to me.
David said that I waited patiently on the Lord, and God inclined unto me. And what else?
And heard my cry.
And heard my cry. That's what
I am. Two. He also brought me up out of a horrible pit, out of the miry clay,
Jesus,
and set my feet upon a rock.
Hold on there. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me up from the slimy pit, out of the muddy mire. He set my feet on the rock.
Amen.
Set my feet on the rock.
Somebody ask him to feel you. That's it. Somebody ask him to feel me again. Somebody say, feel me again. Feel me again. Come on, somebody ask him to feel me again. I need more of you. I need more of you. I've been running on empty.
The Hebrew verb used in chapter number 1, the verse 1, chapter number 40, the verse 1, gives us a clear intensity of how God and David expected the deliverance from God. So number one, anytime we wait patiently upon God, number one, write this thing down. Waiting patiently on God. Anytime we wait patiently on God, God will always incline and hear. I said that God will always incline and hear. Anytime we inquire of the Lord, anytime we wait on God, patiently, God knows you. God knows what you are going through. God knows that you have been waiting for that child for a long time. God knows that you are waiting for that baby for a long time.
Amen.
God knows that you have been waiting for that husband for a long time. God knows that you have been waiting for that wife for a long time. God knows that you have been waiting for that job for a long time. God knows that you are waiting for that scholarship for a long time. God knows that you are waiting for you to be accepted into that school for a long time. God knows that you have been waiting for that contract for a long time. But that doesn't mean that God has forsaken you. Anytime time you wait patiently on God. David said, he inclined unto me and heard me. Amen. It means that God inclines and hears you.
Amen. So, I'm gonna run
what does it mean to incline? It means that God stretches out his hand. It means that God becomes your bona fide anchor. It means that God becomes everything that you have. Everybody in life needs to be heard, because there are issues of life that overwhelms us. There are times we need to speak, we need to express ourselves. But he said that I waited patiently on the Lord, and the Lord inclined unto me and heard me. So the good thing is that anytime you incline unto the Lord will, anytime you wait patiently on God, God will do what? God will incline unto you and hear you.
Amen.
I don't know the one that I'm speaking to tonight.
Gentlemen, over.
But your labor in him will never be in vain.
Amen.
You will never work for somebody to eat the fruit of your labor.
Amen.
God did not bring you to America to put you to bring shame at your doorstep. God brought you here for a purpose.
Amen.
And that purpose will be fulfilled, and it will come to pass.
Jesus.
The devil is a liar. It doesn't matter whatever that has been said. Situations that can never be, that can never, nothing can be done about it.
Yeah.
But the God that I serve is a God of possibilities.
Yes.
Keep on waiting on him.
Amen.
Keep on expecting something from him.
Amen.
Keep on looking up unto him.
Amen.
Keep on holding on to your faith.
Amen.
Keep
Jesus.
On fixing your eyes on him.
Amen.
Because I know out of your waiting will produce the results that you need.
Amen.
And right now I sense within my spirit somebody is expecting the fruit of the womb. And God is saying that tomorrow about this time, you have waited for 5 years.
Yeah.
And tomorrow about this time, God is releasing that baby.
Amen.
Tomorrow about this time, you will carry your baby.
Amen.
Tomorrow about this time, you will not be called that barren woman.
Amen.
You will be called a mother, and your baby will be in your hands. That prophecy is for somebody here listening to me right now. God inclines and hears us. Number two. Anytime we wait patiently on God, anytime we wait patiently on God, God brings you up to set you up. Your waiting on God will bring you up so that God can establish you.
Amen.
God brings you up to set you up.
It takes that, and it takes so much more.
The verse 2, let's read it. He said that he lifted me out of the slimy pit. The pit here was referring to the cistern, the bottom of what? Of a, I mean, the deepest pit.
But the master,
God will bring you out of the pit. Out of that frustration.
Christ.
Out of the place that you cannot even lift up your eyes and you cannot see anything. God will bring you up and set you up.
Amen.
Don't cry. Wipe your tears.
Love.
Wipe your tears. Because I see you smiling tomorrow.
Love.
Your miracle is just right there.
Love.
Somebody shout, I believe.
I believe.
God will bring you up and set you up. God is bringing you up and setting you up.
Amen.
Thank you for your love.
Out of the muddy clay. It is a place that is very slippery. It is a place that you cannot stand. It is a very smooth, rough place. Nothing can hold on what? On muddy clay. Nothing can stick. Nothing can hold. But Bible said that he will bring you out and set your feet on a rock. The meaning of the rock here is that God will establish you and God will give you security. The rock here is a place of stability. So whilst you are patiently waiting, David said, I waited patiently on the Lord. Patiently on the Lord. So the reason why you shouldn't throw in the towel and still believe God, trust God, and know that he's in control is that God will set you up on the rock. It means that you'll be as strong as Pharaoh. You will be very, very strong. You will be established. Your security will be assured and nothing can move you. Nothing at all can move you. Nothing at all can move you. Nothing at all can move you. So David said, he brought me out of the muddy clay and set my foot on the rock. Tonight may God set your foot on the rock. Amen. I said tonight may God set your foot on the rock.
Lord.
May God set you up. Amen. May God bring you up and set you up.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Somebody say tonight.
Tonight.
I am established.
I am established.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Yeah, yeah.
The third thing. The same Psalm chapter number 40. Anytime we wait on God, God gives us a new song. You are saying, Pastor, how is that possible? Anytime I dream, I find myself wearing black cloth and singing some funeral songs. All my songs are so sorrowful songs. All my songs are not encouraging songs. They are not motivating me at all. Let's read the verse 3.
A new song in my mouth.
He said that whilst he waited patiently on the Lord, God put a new song in his mouth.
Amen. Praise to our God.
Praise to our God. Hold on there. He said that, and God put a new song in my mouth. That is the reason why I said that this month of August, God will put a new song in your mouth.
Amen.
I said that God will put a new song in your mouth. Waiting comes with endurance. Through your period of waiting patiently, there will be all kinds of advice, because we have become so impatient said that we can no longer trust God to come through for us. We want everything at the quickest possible time. That is not the way God works. God puts us at a place, say that, you know what, hold on, take your time. There is no magic anywhere. The fact that somebody is having the biggest ministry doesn't mean that you should pass somewhere and get your ministry moving. Everything that comes from Satan's kingdom doesn't last. I said that anything that comes from the camp of the enemy
does not
last. It will get you entertained for a while. But the circumstances and the consequences are more dangerous. Very, very dangerous. So, child of God, listening to me right now, don't force yourself on that man to marry you. Don't force yourself in life. Don't do things that you cannot do. Life is a race, but understand that you cannot do what you cannot do. So take your time, prepare yourself for what God is capable of using you for.
Amen.
There is no need for you to rush. Be you and be yourself. He said that whilst he waited on God, and God patiently, God inclined unto his ears. God set him up and God established him. Said that he set my foot on the rock, and I explained that the rock is a place of stability and security. It is a place that God establishes his children. It is a place that God has what establishes us. It is a place that God establishes. So don't give up, because God is giving you a new song. 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 The last thing is that when we wait on God patiently, our joy and strength is renewed. Somebody say, my strength will be renewed.
My strength will be renewed.
Say, my joy will be renewed.
My joy will be renewed.
There is the need to wait on God.
Yes.
God, it produces the manifold blessings of God.
Amen.
Hope on God. Expect God. Believe God. Don't say that somebody is doing that, so I'll force myself into it. You gonna crash, my brother, my sister. You're gonna crash. But when you believe God and trust God, God will do something in your life.
Amen.
Isaiah 40. Let's read the verse 31. God renews our strength. God renews our strength. As we patiently wait on God, the joy of God inside of us begins to build up, and we begin to find ourselves in a season and time of praising and rejoicing. Isaiah chapter number 40, the verse 31.
But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength.
Mm-hmm.
They shall mount up with wings like eagle.
Hold on there. He said that they will renew their strength. They will do what? Renew their strength. Renew their strength. Renew their strength. Psalm chapter number 27, the verse 14. Psalm 27, the verse 14.
Psalm chapter 27, verses 14.
Let's hear the word of God.
Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Can you get a King James version?
Psalm chapter number 27, the verse 14.
Psalm chapter 27, the verse 14.
Yes.
King James Version, I read. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart.
Jesus.
Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Other version says that hope and expect. Wait, hope, and expect. One verse, it repeats two, three words at the same time. So tonight, the word that I'm leaving with you is that hope, is that wait, hope, and expect from God.
Yes.
And anytime you wait patiently on God, God will incline to you and hear you. God will always going to set you up. And God is going to give you a song. And God is going to renew that joy and renew that strength. May God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless you. May God cause his face to shine upon you. In the name of Jesus, we want to pray this prayer. You are praying that God grant me the grace to patiently wait on you. I don't want to go ahead of you. I don't want to rush in life. I don't want to prematurely do things that will not bring glory to your name. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Somebody talk to God for a minute. Talk to God for
Father,
a minute.
In the name of Jesus. Rabba sutalaba sabadaba. Ramazuki Ramalos Kibriyalaba Los Sabarian Nalaba. Le Karaba Zutalabarian Delebo Sabaria Talaba Satayaba. Le Karaba Zuntalaba Sabaria Telebe Zabra Konto Sabaraba Tayaba. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to your name. Hallelujah to your name.
There is power, there is power in the name, in the name of Jesus.
We know where it is.
God bless you.
Break every chain. Break every chain.
Continue to wait patiently on the Lord.
Come on, sing.
The timings of God are the best.
Break.
Don't rush in life.
Break.
Don't go ahead of God. David said in the book of Psalm chapter number 40, I waited patiently on the Lord. And the Lord set his foot on the rock. May that be your portion tonight. May that be your portion tonight. And say that God set him up. God brought him to a place that he realized that indeed this is the doings of the Lord. I thank God for your life wherever that you are, that you're listening to me. Our Facebook live caught at the middle of it. But yes, you can go to Facebook and you can get me live on there. And I'm believing God and trusting God that next week we'll continue with this subject, waiting patiently on the Lord. Next week, I'm going to pick it from the subject of Abraham and Sarah when God promised them at the age of 75. Isaac was being born at the age of 100. Between that 25 years, what went on? Waiting patiently, waiting patiently, waiting patiently. We shouldn't fall victims about the speed and how things are moving, so that we also want to fall to be victims of these things. It is not everything that is passing that we have to be part of it. We have to take our time in life, build our character, build ourselves, strengthen ourselves, do things right so that we can see God doing something new in our life. I thank God for your life and I pray for you. This Sunday we will be in church from 9:30 to 12:30. Christ Center of Hope, Dallas Assembly of God. Thank you, Dr. Lee, for boying. For last week, Eagles Conference, that was powerful, that was heaven on earth. God answered our prayer. Everybody that came could testify about the move of the Holy Ghost. It was purely impartation, purely prophetic, purely apostolic. He taught us the word of God. It was a combination of everything. And we thank God for your life. This Sunday, we'll be live in church. Wherever that you are, I personally invite you. Come, let's worship together. If you live in this metroplex and you don't have any place of worship, I personally invite you to Christ Center of Hope, Dallas Assemblies of God, and your life will never be the same. Tomorrow is Friday. Tomorrow we are praying for a miracle service from 7 to 9 p.m. Don't be a left out. Come, let us pray together from 7 to 9 p.m. The address is going to be 9560 Skillman Street, Suite number 117, Dallas, Texas, 75243. God bless you. You can visit our website, www.cchchurch.org. You can get us on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook. We are everywhere. On YouTube, you can get our videos, our sermons, also to the Christ Center of Hope, Dallas. And your life will never be the same. May God bless you. May God cause His face to shine upon you. I will see you next week, same time, on Magic Touch Radio. God bless you, Mr. Omare. Anyone that was watching us, God bless you. We love you. And be safe out there. Bye-bye.
The high test is, I'll travel near or far for your glory. I will do anything just to see.